If it's a quiet night out at the beach and your ex-old lady suddenly out of nowhere shows up with a story about her current billionaire land developer boyfriend and his wife and her boyfriend and a plot to kidnap the billionaire and throw him in a loony bin...
I need your help, Doc.
Maybe you should just look the other way.
What made you sign up for the role? I mean, were you a fan of Pynchon, or was it a chance to work with Paul Thomas Anderson again?
Yeah, I hadn't read the book. I didn't know Pynchon's work. I was obviously curious what Paul was doing next. I really enjoyed working with him on The Master. And I read the book, and I thought it was so entertaining. It's unique because it's very funny and outlandish, and yeah. There are these crazy scenarios, but there's a real heart to it. There's a real emotional center to it as well. And I thought it was impressive that he could capture both those kind of feelings. And so it just seemed like it was a really interesting world to experience.
Yeah. I mean, just with the script, I mean, it's so complex and it's really, really layered. I mean, how did you find working with it? Was it daunting in any kind of way, or did you just kind of do it day by day?
It's always daunting.
Yeah.
It's a process. I mean, you know, you get in the first couple weeks, you're just all trying to figure it out. Yeah. But there's so many different elements that come together when you make a film. It's the look of the character, the wardrobe, all of those things. And so it takes some time. And I've tried more and more recently to not impose too many of my ideas prematurely. I try to get on set and try to get the feeling of the other actors before I make too many decisions. It's not really a science. It's just something that it's hard to say. There are times, I think what I like most about it is the times where I don't even really have a strong plan, and I just kind of figure it out as
just
I'm going.
It.
And yeah, and it seems to have more life that way. I feel like, I feel like I don't, my ideas, if I try to push my ideas, it's just going to feel false.
Mm-hmm. I mean, the preparation for it, I mean, did you talk to any PIs? Did you talk to any people from the era or anything like that?
I didn't talk to any PIs or anyone from the era. Primarily, it was the book that we had. But Paul's really into music. It's a big part of his films. So he always gives you music to listen to. And so I had these CDs that I listened to daily. There are a number of books. You know, I just have in my trailer, you just have a bunch of books, photo books and things like that. And sometimes you come in and you don't even really know. You know, sometimes I'm not even searching for anything in particular. You're just kind of glancing through and you see what affects you, and there's different things that you might want to try and use.
Are you the Great Beast?
Oh. No, that's a policeman.
You know you're driving without your headlights, ma'am?
But I can see in the dark.
Perhaps you shouldn't be driving then. I'm going to need to see all your IDs, please.
And what is this all about, sir?
Any gathering of three or more civilians is now considered a possible cult.
What? It's Charlie Manson again?
Criteria includes reference to the Book of Revelation, males with shoulder-length hair or longer, and endangerment through inattentive driving, all of which y'all have been exhibiting.
Oh, I don't think so.
Man, listen, this is a Mercedes.
Okay.
It's only painted one color.
Y'all hang tight.
That should count for something. That should get a point.
Okay.
I'm actually gonna have a heart attack. Actually, my heart is racing like a little.
This is, like I said, this is your second film of Paul Thomas Anderson, and I mean, do you see yourself working with him again, or is it a case of how the script works for you?
I really like working with Paul, and of course, I'd love to work with him again. And if there's something that comes up that feels right for both of us, then we'll do it.
Cool. It's a great cast with this as well. Like you've got Reese Witherspoon and Josh Brolin as well. How did you find working with all of them? How was the process for them? Because it's a fantastic cast and it's a big cast as well.
Yeah. No, it was great. I mean, every time Paul would come and say, this person was cast, I couldn't believe it. It was like the next person was just as good as the last. And so I was really, I felt really honored to work with everybody. I mean, I've been a huge fan of Josh for a long time and Benicio. I've never worked with Benicio. And so that was great. It was a fantastic cast.
Hey, Sanj.
What's up, Doc? You know you have no case here. So if you're going to charge them, you bet them.
Otherwise, you have to let him go.
Sanj, remember who this is you're talking to? That's Bigfoot Bjornsson, Renaissance cop.
I know who he is. So, what's the beef here exactly?
It doesn't have much to do with your specialty, which I understand is marine law.
We got plenty of crime on the high seas, Lieutenant.
Okay, well, so far we have murder and kidnapping. We can work in pirates if it would make you more comfortable. Either way, it's high profile.
Yeah, but given your history of harassment with my client, this will never make it to trial.
No, I think we could probably take this all the way to trial, but with our luck, you know, the jury pool will be 99% hippie.
Well, that's a chance of venue to maybe like Orange County. Not as many hippies down there, you know?
Sarge, who are you working for?
Clients pay me for work, Doc. Clients pay me for work, Doc.